What's going on, everybody? DJ GoHam here. Welcome back to the channel.
It's Farms and Tools, man.
Hashtag Farms and Tools. Today, we've got 33 PC mods in testing. We've got 25 console mods in testing. Giants are bringing something very different and new to Farming Simulator. A2 Square Studios got some information on the TLX 2020. A-Dub Modding shows off the Massey Pack. Northeast Farm Group have a very unique piece of equipment for us. Sid Modding shows off his 8RX EU version. Peter716 brings us his first map. Plus, Custom Modding want to know what you think. Let's check it out. In testing for PC, we have a pack of trash cans. Yep. Aggerleaf Farm. Agricultural Brick Shed. Basketball, let's go. Big Barn. Bobcat 863 Turbo with Shovel. Cantabria Infinite. Case Magnum 8900 Series. Challenger MT900 Series. Connell HW80 Pack. Duitz Far 5100. Fertilizer YPEX. Small House. Jackto Uniport 2000 Plus. La Coronella 2.0. Large Machine Hall. Lizard Pig Feeding Systems. Lizard Tank 40, Lubelska Dolina, Machine Shelter, Nefes 8560, New Park Farm, we're going to talk about this later on, Oler STT-180, Placeable Fuel Tank, Polish Seed Pallets, Pottinger Euroboss Pack, Sosnovka Chicken Pen, Starliner 4045H Cutter Trailer, Tank Trailer IBM 285, Tattoo DCA, Technosema BA200SP, Vicon Vibraflow 1500, and Wind Turbine Pack. In testing for console players, we have the Barnwood Silos, Cinderella 11, Excalibur, FarmTech EDK500 TDK900, Hauer Front Loader Pack, Hay Shed, John Deere 9600 9610, John Deere 9650, Joskin Modulo 10500, Keyawake, Kuhn VB3160, Large Machinery Shed, Lizard 18-foot Silage Trailer, Lizard 60, Lizard Loader 863 with Shovel, I believe this is a Bobcat Lizard version, Lizard LT20 Triaxle, Manor House, Open Shed, Polish Chicken Coop, Small Polish Garage, Starliner 4045H Cutter Trailer, Ursa C355 4x2, Ursa C355 4x4, Water Tank 2000L, and welcome to Stone Valley X2. This is the update. With all that being said, we still have 17 mods sitting waiting to be tested, and the current average waiting time for newly submitted mods is 2 workdays. Giant Software have entered into a partnership with EIT Food and John Deere called the Precision Farming Project. They say that precision farming is coming to Farming Simulator. The focus of this project is the implementation of precision farming into Farming Simulator, and the project will take over the span of about 2 years, likely crossing into the next FS game. Public knowledge about farming is in decline and shows that it is possible to produce high quality and organic crops on small farms as well as larger ones, and to show that precision farming technology allows big farms to produce high quality goods while being environmentally friendly as well. This is planned as a free game module for Farming Simulator and introduced through various new gameplay features. While the exact course of the development of the final module is yet to be determined, the first feature of the module will introduce heterogeneous fields into regards to the soil types. Very interesting. Meaning the player will be able to manage different zones by using variable rate technologies. Sustainability and technical efficiency scores will quantify the result of your actions when using precision farming tech in the game. Many features are planned to follow in the future. Since the project is currently in the concept phase, more information will be revealed later in the project's process. Over the course of 2 years, not necessarily the next 2 years, Giants will update us on new information about the development of both the module as well as the project itself. No other information is known at this time, and it is kind of confusing since we know so little about the in-game process itself, but Giants do say to stay tuned for more information coming soon. We shall see. A2 Square Studio posted saying that testing for his TLX 2020 series has completed, but even at the time of recording, we don't have any further information. And I've been talking with David this morning and we're both pretty confused. Testing completed doesn't always mean a mod has passed testing, so we could see it later today. We might not see it for another week. However, by the time this video releases, we should have a better understanding of what is happening with this mod. I will post more information on my Facebook page later today once it's available. Make sure you guys check that out. Link in the description. While we wait, here's some pics of the 20-foot gooseneck that's going to be sent out for testing today. This, as with the TLX 2020 series, is meant for all platforms. A-Dub teases us today with a few more pics from the old-gen Massey Pack, which is awaiting a few more fixes, and it's going to be ready to be sent off for testing with Giants. Here we get to see the Track Massey, which A-Dub says, as with all the tractors in the pack, are very well balanced when used correctly and will lift heavy weights compared to their size. Very cool, very powerful. Northeast Farm Group dropped some pics of something very unique that I've never seen before. This was said to be a crimper, which helps dry hay faster. Very likely will be used to pick up swaths and tend the entire thing at once. No other information is known, at least publicly right now, about this machine, But it's really cool to see something like this. I already have a few ideas for it myself. Big shout out to Nate Rink for helping me understand this machine in the post on NEFG Modding's page. Appreciate you, bro. Thank you. Said Modding has posted a new screenshot of his John Deere 8RX EU version. He says that the 8RX is now ready, and he's going to be working on the 8 and 7 series tractors later today. Sid finished the post by saying, coming soon to ModHub. These will be in addition to the updates to the US versions in the 2020 John Deere Tractor Pack for all platforms. Earlier in the video, I mentioned a map, New Park Farm, which is in testing right now for PC players. This is the first map by Peter716, who's been working on the map for quite a while now. It looks like this map is intended for PC, but could release on console. You never know, we'll just have to wait and see. The map will include a main farmyard with cows, sheep, pigs, and grain storage. There'll also be a smaller farmyard with sheep and pigs. It will also include a market, BGA, grain sale point, dealership, 33 fields, and 3 logging areas. All animals and placeables are built into the map as placeables for more in-game customization, so you can do whatever you want. You can make it however you want, and that is super cool. The map will be seasons ready and have road traffic as well. It appears to be a smaller map, maybe around the same size as Mercury Farms, maybe a little bit smaller. Because the map is in testing for the first time, it will likely not pass, since I've never seen a map pass the first time through testing, and Peter716 does not expect it to pass the first time either. However, they have said that they will keep us updated on the testing process in the coming days. This is a very good looking map, and I can't wait to try it out for myself. And lastly today, Customonic says that their new Demco 1200 gallon side quest tanks are in game. These will be available for both PC and console players as well, but as a Lizard brand on consoles. They asked, besides Custom Modding's 8R, what other tractor would you like to see these on? I personally think it'd be cool to see them on Custom Modding 7R, but that's just me. What do you think? Let me know down in the comment section below. Just like every episode of Farm Sim News, links to all topics discussed today can be found in the description below. There's no release dates for mods, so myself nor anyone else knows when anything is going to be released. If I didn't talk about something that you're interested in or curious about, that just simply means that there is no new information at the time of recording on that thing. So make sure you stay tuned to the channel for up-to-date information on everything going on the World of Farming Simulator. Well, guys, that is going to be it for today. I hope you've enjoyed. If you did, make sure you drop a like on the video. Get subscribed to the channel if you're new and join the GoHam fam. Make sure you turn your notification bells on as well so that you never miss daily Farming Simulator videos here on the channel. Usually, Farm Sim News is a Monday through Friday series. Seeing that today's Friday, very likely will not have Farm Sim News tomorrow or Sunday. However, last week we did have a lot of information Saturday, and I did make Farm Sim News. I will do that again tomorrow or Sunday if we have enough information. So stay tuned to that. All being said, I hope you have a great day. We will see you later. Peace. Every time I wear a face mask, I feel like I'm going in to rob a bank.